station with time to spare. From there in the waiting room out of the bar, he is hailed by an extraordinarily pleasant young man. Don't you remember me, Fyodor Ivanek? Fyodor Ivanek has difficulty remembering. Well, not exactly. You see, although the young man, however, is overflowing with friendly concern. Come now, how can that be? I have to remind you. And he bows respectfully to Fyodor Ivanich's wife. You must forgive us. I'll keep him only 1 minute. The wife accedes, and trustingly the husband lets himself be led away by the arm forever for 10 years. The station is thronged and no one notices anything. Oh, you citizens who love to travel. Do not forget that in every station there are a GPU branch and several prison cells. This importunity of alleged acquaintances is so abrupt that only a person who has not had the wolfish preparation of camp life is likely to pull back from it. Do not suppose, for example, that if you are an employee of the American Embassy by the name of Alexander P., you cannot be arrested in broad daylight on Gordon Street, right by the Central Telegraph Office. Your unfamiliar friend dashes through the press of the crowd and opens his thundering arms to embrace you, Sasha. He simply shouts at you, with no effort to be inconspicuous. Long time no see. Come on over. Let's get out of the way. At that moment, a Corvette sedan draws up to the curb. And several days later, TASS will issue an angry statement to all the papers alleging that informed circles of the Soviet government have no information on the disappearance of Alexander V. But what's so unusual about that? Our boys have carried out such arrests in Brussels, which was where Zora Blednov was seized, not just in Moscow. One has to give the organs their due, their name when public. Can I the Gulag Archipelago? Speeches, the plays in art theaters, and women's fashions all seem to have come off assembly lines. Arrests can be of the most varied kind. They take you aside in the factory corridor after you have had your pass checked and were arrested. They take you from a military hospital with a temperature of 102, as they did with Anne's bench gun, and the doctor will not raise a peep about your arrest, just let him try. They'll take you right off the operating table as they took Anne. Anne, horrified, a school inspector, in 1936, in the middle of an operation for stomach ulcer, and drag you off to a cell, as they did him, half alive and all bloody ass. Harpunik recollects, oh, like Nadia Levitt's life, you try to get information about your mother's sentence, and they give it to you, but it turns out to be a confrontation and your own arrest. In the gastronomic fancy food store, you are invited to the special order department and arrested there. You are arrested by a religious pilgrim whom you have put up for the night, for the sake of Christ. You are arrested by a needleman who has come to read your electric needle. to go all the way to a hut at night, with no roads to travel on. They are summoned to the village Soviet and arrested there. Manual workers are called into the office. Of course, every machine has a point at which it is overloaded, beyond which it cannot function. In the strained and overloaded years of 1945 and 1946, when trainload after trainload poured in from Europe, to be swallowed up immediately and sent off to the rest by 11 blew off, all that excessive theatricality went out the window, and the whole theory suffered greatly. All the fuss and feathers of ritual went flying in every direction, and the arrest of tens of thousands took on the appearance of a swallowed roll call. They stood there with lists, read off the names of those on one train, loaded them onto another, and that was the whole arrest. For several decades, political arrests were distinguished in our country precisely by the fact that people were arrested who were guilty of nothing and were therefore unprepared to put up any resistance whatsoever. There was a general feeling of being destined for destruction, a sense of having nowhere to escape from the GPU-NKVD, which, incidentally, given our internal passport system, was quite accurate. And even in the fever of epidemic arrests, when people leaving the world said farewell to their families every day, because they could not be certain they would return at night, even then almost no one tried to run away, and only in rare cases did people commit suicide. And that was exactly what was required. A submissive sheep is a fine for a wolf. This submissiveness was also due to ignorance of the mechanics of epidemic arrests. By and large, the organs had no profound reasons for their choice of whom to arrest and whom not to arrest. They merely had overall assignments, quotas for a specific number of arrests. These quotas might be filled on an orderly basis or wholly arbitrary. In 1937, a woman came to the reception room of the Novikov-Test NKVD test where she should be about the infant and the infant of a neighbor who had been arrested. They said, "Sit down, we'll find out." She sat there for 2 hours, whereupon they took her and tossed her into a cell. They had a total plan which had to be fulfilled in a hurry, and there was no one available to send out into the city. And here was this woman already in their hands. On the other hand, the NKVD did come to get the Latvian Andre Pavel Miloorchuk. But he didn't open the door. He jumped out the window, escaped, and shot straight to Siberia. And even though he lived under his own name, and it was clear from his documents that he had come from Russia, he was never arrested, nor summoned to the organs, nor subjected to any suspicion whatsoever. After all, search for wanted persons falls into three categories: all union, Republican, and provincial. And the jury, well, the Gulag Archipelago, suited nearly half of those arrested, and those epidemics would have been confined to the provinces. A person marked for arrest by virtue of chance circumstances, such as a neighbor's denunciation, could be easily replaced by another neighbor. Others, like Andre Pavel, who found themselves in a trap or an ambush department by accident, and who were bold enough to escape immediately, before they could be questioned, were never caught and never charged, while those who stayed behind to await justice got a term in prison. And the overwhelming majority almost all behaved just like that, without any spirit, helplessly, with a sense of doom. It is true, of course, that the NKVD, in the absence of the person it wanted, would make his relatives guarantee not to leave the area. And, of course, it was it quietly and dare to vote. Since you aren't guilty, then how can they arrest you? It's a mistake. They are already dragging you along by the collar, and you still keep on explaining to yourself, it's a mistake. They set things straight and let me out. Others are being arrested en masse, and that's a bothersome